know, Darwin talked about natural selection a lot, but he also talked about sexual selection a lot. And until recently, last 30 years or so, biologists tend to concentrate more on natural selection. But, you know, women are hypergamous in the extreme. They mate up and across hierarchies of competence or power. I think competence fundamentally. And that means that our whole evolutionary history was shaped by the selection of consciousness. And so, like, the mechanism that generates random variation and allows for the menu from which the selection is made, that might be random, but the selection process is bloody well not random. And it looks to me like men's consciousness elevates men to positions of status, and women's consciousness selects those men. And they're not selected on the basis of power. That's not true. That's not even true of chimpanzees, by the way. And they're more violent and much more primitive than we are. So, like, that deep ethic that we're talking about, that doesn't run itself out. Even, it's certainly not only Western. It doesn't even look like it's only human. And Franz de Waal, who I'm going to be talking to at some point on this podcast, has made very much of that, you know, that there's this natural ethic that you see emerging in chimpanzee behavior, in their hierarchical behavior within troops. So he said the tyrannical chimps get torn to shreds by their subordinates who band together. You can dominate the group with power, but it's very unstable.